Greetings for the Odins, welcome back to Mortal Defoes. In this episode, we are going to be starting a shared campaign with the mission Exodus. The objective seems to be pretty simple, rescue the hostage from being held in a terrorist camp designated Objective Tremor. So this is more earthquake themed. However, what I find a little disconcerting here is whether this mission requires stealth, and if that is the case, whether, you know, alerting the enemies might mean that the hostage is dead. In which case, it's actually going to be a pretty difficult mission to pull off, and I might have to, you know, go online to look for some save files if I'm unable to, you know, complete this mission. Since this game, I don't know whether it's just, you know, modern hardware, or whether this game was like that ever since the very beginning, seems to not be suitable for any kind of stuff whatsoever. Or maybe I'm just not trying hard enough. Let's see. We can probably try to take a huge detour if that is the issue. Curious map. And the terrain changes quite a bit. It seems to have lots of very, very steep hills. The terrain here, I mean. And our objective is quite a long walk from the starting position. I think this would be the objective here. Number 4. And there are enemies all around the area, of course. I see one more ally. Anyway, let's read the mission briefing. Your insertion point is 700 meters south of Objective Tremor. Proceed north through your checkpoints to the objective. Secure the release of the hostage and proceed immediately to the extraction point. Should you meet any enforcing difficulties, abort the mission and proceed directly to the extraction point. Huh, that is interesting. I wonder what unforeseen difficulties mean, like a chopper or anything. I wonder what's going to be, you know, what's going to happen in this mission. It seems very ominous. So anyway, expect enemy forces, signals, expected enemy forces, signals intelligence, SIGINT, suggests the terrorists have a company-sized force operating from the space. The most recent reconnaissance overflights of the base show no heavy weaponry within the camp. However, multiple two-man patrols were noted throughout the perimeter area. Allied support. Alpha team will insert 700 meters west of the objective, then proceed to a position from which they can support your ingress and clear your egress route. Once you have secured the hostage, they will rendezvous with you at the extraction point. The situation. The Chad National Liberation Front, CNLF, an extremist political faction with known ties to international terrorism, has taken responsibility for the kidnapping of an American oil company CEO. Huh, would they really send a, you know, Delta Force detachment there? Not just, not a detachment, I mean, like two squads there, if a private citizen of the USA got arrested? Not just a question that I'm curious about. Anyway, for kidnapping of an American oil company CEO. The CEO was in the process of negotiating a major deal to aid the Chad's government attempts to exploit its petroleum wealth. In the CNLF statement of responsibility, they demanded that all U.S. aid to Chad be ended or the hostage would be killed. In a gesture of good relations, the Chadian government has agreed to allow the U.S. to deploy a special forces team within Chad to recover the kidnapped man. I wonder what this could lead to. Anyway, so this is what I want to look into, whether they would recommend that I go for a more stealthy approach. And judging by the way things are designed in this game, I doubt there is any other weapon which provides stealth, so I guess we're stuck with that. And this, I guess. Anyway, if you try with the submachine gun, although it is extremely difficult to do so, primarily because of the level design and how the terrain is not at all friendly for anything, you know, beyond 100 meters. And yeah, I mean, you need to get really up close and personal when you want to take out all these enemies with the SMG. So I'll try it with the SMG first if that doesn't work, and stealth is not mandatory, I will consider switching over to a more, a louder weapon if required. Anyway, without further ado, let's just go ahead and start this mission. Let's see what this is all about. Now, I do have
okay, a... Bravo. You guys have a nice walk in the park.
Now, here's the thing. I do have a laser designator, and I honestly don't know why I would like to use it. But yeah, I can definitely try using it in this mission at least. I also have a knife, which seems quite useless, if you ask me. But anyway. Now, this is attempt number 3, just for full disclosure. And the previous 2 attempts, in case I haven't showed you, showed me that the enemy AI in this game is very difficult. Guess what? This is a pretty damn good gun. Pretty damn good. I didn't expect a 22 caliber to be this good. There should be 2 people out here. In the end, it does in fact boil down to, you know, eliminate everybody, because once you get spotted, then it's pretty much the end of the story for you. You keep getting spotted again.
Alpha problem. In position. We'll clear the extraction route after you locate the hostage.
And yeah, those 2 guys are dead. I'll just take care of the guys under this hill here. There are 2 other people right here. I didn't realize that the last time until I practically walked into them. One of them should be right here. Well placed headshot. It actually took 2. I don't know why. But the good thing about this gun is that you can actually shoot while reloading. Or rather, this game. But anyway, there should be 2 more people up there. Now would probably be the time for me to go in gun spacing. Or maybe I'll try to wing it with this pistol. I've only got 8 bullets left in it anyway. So, yeah. One of these days I actually went to that pass, and it was a good experience. It was a pretty good experience. One of the things about this game that I will tell you definitely not to do is try and follow the objective markers down to the T. Because if you do, these objective markers are bad. They're horrible. I don't know whether they made it to, you know, keep the new players away or something, but they are horrible. Or maybe it's just, you know, modern computational power combined with how old this game is that the game feels very unbalanced in that regard, for me at least. But okay, time to start the shootout, because stealth seems to be an optional thing for this game entirely. I mean, hey, you are dead. You can die. Yeah, thank you. Die, please. Now, you see, just the presence of a scoped weapon can change the entire battlefield for you in a game like this. Now, where are you and who are you shooting at? I thought that was you. I guess it's not. Where are you shooting from? Son, where are you? I see. Wait, did you just shoot your own mate? Oh, I thought you got shot by your roommate, or you shot your roommate. I guess those are the sounds of my friends firing? Nope, that is the enemy firing at me. From where, I cannot tell. Probably the one on top of this hill here. Good thing those 2 guards are out on patrol. But no, I think it's somebody firing at me from behind. Although that can... that is not really possible. That's your friend dead. And is there anybody over here? Nope. They're over here somewhere on this feature. And yeah, can't say I see anybody else over here. Everybody here is dead. Anyway, let's just proceed on towards the objective. I'll leave those guys be. They can come in, come and do their own shenanigans later. This time around, I'll just try the strategy that I tried the first time, which is just looking to find this person who I saw on top of the hill on the map. But yeah, previously what happened was I climbed up on top of this hill and yeah, my buddy said, and then I died. This time I'll try to do the same, climb on top of this hill, but I'll try to make it so that my buddies, well, they'll be dying anyway, but that I do not die. So yeah, it seems that the odds are stacked against my comrades. You know, that is the Alpha team. And they have already started their, you know, they've already started clearing the way out for my incursion. Okay, that guy's dead. And who else is trying to kill my buddies here?
Alpha to Bravo, we've broken the perimeter. Moving towards the motor pool.
Very good, very good. And who's trying to kill you guys? Is there anybody trying to kill you? Is there any mean guy here? Where are you? I mean, somebody's shooting with a pistol. I don't know who it is. Might be somebody in here. I do not see anybody here though, so that is good. There are supposed to be a lot of people there. Let me go ahead and try to, you know, if there is somebody here. Because there was somebody there the last time and they like completely wrecked me. I cannot see anybody behind me at this point, but yeah, there's nobody here. People are trying to shoot me. People are trying to shoot me. No problem, sir. I do not see anybody here. Nobody. There was previously a dead body in there. That guy said. And who else is shooting at me? I cannot spot anybody here. I really do hope that Alpha Team makes it out alive in this edition of the mission.
Bravo King 6, the hostage should be in the tent near you. Hostage.
I do not
Alpha King, there is no hostage. I repeat, no one home, no hostage.
Bravo King 6, they have moved the hostage. Abort mission. I repeat, abort mission. Get out, get out, get out.
Acknowledged.
Black Widow, King 6, move to extract. Mission is scrubbed.
Acknowledged, King 6, moving to extraction now. Actually, I was moving the opposite direction. I should have been moving this way. My bad, King 6. I will now move to extraction. I don't know why I wait to let the ADS set in before I shoot. When I can just shoot without letting the ADS set in. I guess one of the bad habits is that Call of Duty has ingrained in me at this point. Especially since you cannot turn the ADS on or off in this game. I do hope that the Alpha team makes it this time round. I do believe I have said this before, but I feel the need to say it again. Primarily because of how... Oh wait, the extraction is this way. I'm sorry. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, time to move out of this village. I feel like I'm a little directionally challenged. Because on the map I thought the extraction was someplace else, but it turns out not to be. And these are my buddies, Alpha 1 and 2. I hope the extraction does not suddenly
King
turn
six, Bravo is secure.
Hot.
We'll meet up at Objective Zulu. Okay, Bravo, you guys have a nice walk in the park.
I accidentally skipped the dialogue there, but anyway, I'll just end the mission and show you guys the debriefing. So, apparently there was a hostage in there. There should have been a hostage, there was instead a enemy shooting at me. An enemy with a special skin, if I might add. Okay, zero kills obviously because I accidentally restarted the game when I was trying to, you know, get rid of the zoom. I'll be mindful not to do that again. Although the hostage was moved, the rescue mission went very smoothly. Yeah, I mean, Alpha team did not die this playthrough, so that is obviously nice. During the mission, information was recovered that would help lead to the new location of the hostage. Evidence was found during the raid that suggests the identity of one of the hostage takers and points to the location of an enemy base camp. Okay, that's interesting. Bravo team is ordered to stand prepared once mission planning is finished for the next step in the in rescuing the hostage. So I guess we are trying to, you know, rescue just one hostage, maybe the American CEO, throughout this entire campaign, but who knows. But yeah, that was Exodus for now. We have two new missions unlocked. One of them is Carrion and the other is Snake Eyes. So the names of the missions seem to be biblical, I suppose. Snake Eyes, Carrion, Exodus. And the names of the objectives seem to be impact themed. Blast. This one for Carrion is Blast, for Exodus it was, I believe, Tremor. Yeah, and for Snake Eyes it is Steam. Yeah, no, I'm wrong. Anyway, I'll stop trying to extrapolate data that I do not have, and I will see you guys in the next mission, whether that'll be Carrion or Snake Eyes. But until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Oathlings.